Good morning, people watching at 65. Lisa Boyce here. I'm going to give you the gospel. It's in 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4, which is the basis of our salvation, why we're saved, why we're kept saved. Christ spilled his blood for our past, present, and future sins, was buried, and rose again on the third day according to Scripture. We're saved by grace through faith in Christ alone. Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing else. It is grace through faith in Christ alone. Not of ourselves, not of works, lest any man should boast. We don't come to him thinking that we could lose our salvation or thinking that we could walk away from it. Because if you think that, you never had it in the first place. The Bible says that. 1 John 2. Look it up. It's right there. We come to him believing in what he's already done. And what he's already taken care of through his blood. It is grace that God gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him will not perish but have eternal life. That's the gospel, period. Once you are saved, once you accept Christ as Savior, you believe in him. I mean, you're not going to accept someone unless you believe in him. So you, once you accept Christ as Savior, you automatically believe in him. And you are sealed until the day of redemption. I don't know how many times I have to explain that to people. You were sealed until the day of redemption. The Holy Spirit literally changes you. He comes into you and leads you to righteousness, and he changes you. I can't make it no simpler than that. That's the gospel. Period. People write me and say, well, we could walk away from that. Well, if you walk away from it, you never had it. Let's just be real. I'm just being honest. If you walk away from it, why? I mean, you never had it. That's the truth. And that's something nobody wants to talk about. But I'm just coming out to tell you what it's just, you just never had it. Why would you want to walk away from it? You wouldn't want to. This is why I put emphasis on the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit changes you and leads you to righteousness. Why would you want to walk away from the Lord? That means you never knew him in the first place. I'm going to come on here and I'm going to show you how close we are to the rapture. I do this every day. We are very, very close to the rapture of the church. Tulsi Gabbard. Now she was the she was one of the politicians in Hawaii. She's a Democrat, but she's more of a moderate. They hate her. The Democrats did not want her to run for anything. They really don't like her because she's too much of a moderate. But she made a good point here. She said that Sleepy Joe is moving the U.S. towards a nuclear war with Russia. She made this yesterday. She says that former Hawaii Democrat Congresswoman Tulsi Gabbard is warning that the Biden administration policies could potentially lead the U.S. into a nuclear war with Russia, resulting in suffering beyond comprehension, hundreds of millions of people dying, and the end of the world as we know it. I can't believe someone like that said that, but it's absolutely true. It goes on to say, the warning came while she was recently on Tucker Carlson Tonight. Where she stressed that a failure to de-escalate tensions between Moscow over Ukraine could result in nuclear conflict. The backdrop of her concerns is centered around the recent actions that the Sleepy Joe administration has taken as it imposed a broad array of sanctions on Russia to punish it for alleged interference in the 2020 U.S. election, cyber hacking, bullying Ukraine and other malign acts. The measures blacklisted Russian companies, expelled Russian diplomats, and placed limits on the Russian sovereign debt market, according to Reuters. Tucker asked Gabbard whether the Russian-Ukraine situation is moving towards war, and I got a reflection coming in off the light. Sorry about that. And if some of our leaders relish the prospect, the former congresswoman stated, "It is moving in a very dangerous direction. And the question for the American people is, are we willing to go to war with Russia on behalf of Ukraine?" Well, the Bible says this is going to happen. So there you go. As we need to understand that such a war will come at the cost beyond anything that we can really imagine, because this is not a war that is just okay. That is going to be something that's happening to someone else, somewhere else on the other side of the world. No, this is something that will directly impact everybody. It says, this is a war that is not a game. It's a war in which there are no winners. Because you've got thousands of nuclear weapons that the United States has aimed towards Russia. Russia has thousands of nuclear weapons aimed towards the U.S. So this thing will lead to a nuclear war. When? I don't know. Hopefully it's after the rapture. Well, that would be something if the rapture happens while the nuclear war is going on. That could happen too. I'm going to link this article in the description box. Folks, this is how close we are. This is how close we are. And what's happening is that, like I said, in the time past, those who are watching for the coming of the Lord, we see what's going on. We're well aware of what's going on. We take what's happening in the news and apply it to the Bible. Because everything that's happening in the news, and I've said it time and time again, it's related to the tribulation, and it's leading to the tribulation. If we're this close to the tribulation, how much closer are we to the rapture? I put an article on my blog this morning, and I put one up there yesterday about Macron. So you might want to look at that. It's funny that they're calling for Macron for peace. Go look at the article. It's off of End Times Headlines. I'm going to link this article in the description box, and I will, if anything else comes up, nothing, I didn't see anything last night, so I didn't come up with anything. But if anything comes up today, I'll be back. Thank you.